Welcome to Grundy Tech Bytes. We're going to be learning about the Let's Go Code activity set, and this is by Learning Essentials. This set teaches early coding and programming skills, and it's perfect for classroom use. It's great for ages 5 and above, and it's a really fun, easy to learn, kinesthetic, tactile learning activity. Today, we're going to be looking at exactly what is included in this set, how to set it up, and we're going to look at some sample mazes. So let's get started. Here's the instruction booklet for the game, and as you can see, it's perfect for ages 5 and up and grades kindergarten and above. Then we also include a getting started guide. Now, we're going to take a look at some of the special pieces you'll see within this game. These are the starting arrows, and you'll place them on the starting points for the game. You'll use one or both arrows depending on if it's a one-person game or two-player game. These are the robots. There's a yellow and blue robot, and they are the goal. You're trying to be coded to get through this game to get to these robots. Next, you'll see the springs. There's a yellow and blue spring, which need to be picked up and taken back to the robot for repairs. There's also a yellow and blue gear piece, and these gears need to be picked up and taken back to the robot for repairs as well. When you see one of these X's on a spot, that means that that spot is blocked for that player. Next, let's look at the action coding cards. These coding cards need to be placed in the correct sequence to code the player to successfully get through the maze. There's lots of different ones, including forward, back, turn left, turn right. There's a jetpack, which allows you to fly over blocked spaces, a claw, which allows you to pick up an object, or my personal favorite, the wild card. Next, let's take a look at the mats. Within this game, you'll receive 20 foam mats, and they come in blue, green, orange, and purple. You'll use these mats to form your maze. Now, let's look at some examples. In the instruction booklet, there's some sample mazes, which I've set up here so you can see them. This is the first one, and you can see that there's the yellow arrow on the starting space, and you need to get to the yellow robot. This is another sample. You can see that it's a bit more complicated because it utilizes the gear, which needs to be picked up, and it also has a blocked space, which needs the jetpack to get over. Here's a bigger maze. This is for the blue player. In this image, you can see the start arrow. You can see that there's also a blocked space, a gear, and then the robot. And here's another. This is an example for two players, the yellow player and the blue player. So let's wrap up. The Let's Go Code activity set by Learning Essentials teaches early coding and programming skills. It's great for ages 5 and above. It's a kinesthetic and tactile learning activity. It's a great screen-free coding option. It's easy and fun to learn. And this activity can be used with one or more players. It's a collaborative game, and it's perfect for classroom use. I hope you had fun learning about the Let's Go Code activity set by Learning Essentials, and we'll see you at our next Grundy Tech Bytes video.